So here is the man whose idea this was, getting to choose his golden year. It's Chris Benson. Hi, Chris.
Hi, Ken. Thanks for having me on. Thank you. Great to be here.
Well, thank you for having such a good idea. How did the idea come to you?
Well, basically, I love 60s music. I'd say I'm an 80s kid at heart. I love 80s music, but I do love other genres. I love and I love 50s, 60s, 70s, right the way through. And I just thought, you know what? 60s music seems to be forgotten about. And why? I mean, on TV, we still play 60s films, you know, Lawrence of Arabia, True Grit. All those are still on kind of round the clock. Why is 60s music forgotten about? There's so many great tunes, and yet we just don't seem to hear them as often as we should. And if a song's good, a song's always good. And for me, that was the reason why I kind of approached Greatest Hits Radio with the idea.
You're absolutely right, because, I mean, 60s music, a lot of that influenced the music of the 70s and the 80s and the 90s. So the roots are all there in the 60s for people to hear, and that's why we should still be hearing them. So you've been a listener to Greatest Hits Radio for how long?
I'd say about 18 months or so now. I think the first show I discovered was the late night Andy Crane show, which is still brilliant. And in a morning, whilst I'm taking the kids to school, hello Eric, Josie and Arthur. Normally on the way to school, we're listening to Rossi and his breakfast show, trying to guess the morning mystery oldie. And I love Greatest Hits Radio because I think it's got a good interaction with the listeners, especially you do, Ken, especially, and not many stations have that, and I really do applaud that.
Well, and it's not aimed particularly at your age, because you're a little perhaps younger than some listeners to our station.
Thank you. I don't, that's a compliment.
Well, you want to see the age of some of them, to be honest.
but you know what? I think it's really important. It's a good link between the listeners, and the fact that you Greatest Hits have invited me in to talk about this. You listened to your feedback, and I think that it was a lovely surprise. It was.
Well, Secret 60s, what a great idea. Was the name yours?
It was. I just thought in my head it was this little kind of underground club where, you know, oh, we're not meant to like 60s music anymore, but you know what? It's still there if you want to listen to it. And Greatest Hits Premium's already got a 70s dedicated station. It's got a brilliant album station and obviously 80s and 90s. And I thought, well, why not 60s? You know, why not? I mean, during different times of the day, different times of the week, we might want to listen to different types of music. And there should be a place, a go-to place to listen to 60s music still. So it seems a good home.
Well, you've come up with a fantastic name, fantastic home for that kind of music. And we want you now to remember your golden year. So which is the year you've gone for?
I've gone for the year that England won the World Cup. It seems a good year in the middle of the decade, 1966. Obviously, there's so many different styles of music already by 1966. And I found it really hard to pick just three songs. Obviously, the summer of 66 had some great number ones, and there were some brilliant tracks that didn't even make the top 10 in 1966. So that's how good the charts were.
And the first one you've gone for is a Simon and Garfunkel track. So why have you chosen this?
Homeward Bound is a song for me that has grown on me as I've got older. I didn't really appreciate it in my teens or my 20s, but it really hits home every time I hear it now. And and apologies to people from Widnes, because I always thought the song was written in Crewe. And then when I was researching this, I discovered it was in Widnes, and there's a plaque in Widnes Railway Station where Paul Simon apparently wrote it. But it's a great song. When I think it's almost 60 years old, that doesn't sound right, but it's a superb piece of music.
And you can't really picture him on Widnes Station there with that guy.
No, I'm going to have to go and see the blue plaque now.
We'll all go there. What's the next track going to be?
The next track I've picked is Jimmy Ruffin, What Becomes of the Broken Hearted. I love Jimmy Ruffin. Farewell is a Lonely Sound is a terrific track. And Jimmy Ruffin often seems to be forgotten about, and I don't know why. Superb vocalist. And this would be one of my all-time favourite songs, let alone a song from 1966. So it was probably the first one I decided on when picking songs for this show. Terrific record.
You're quite right. And one of the best introductions ever in popular music, I think.
I have to agree with you. I mean, it's just one of those that you can instantly recognise as well, isn't it? And I'm always singing along with every time I hear it.
You've only got one left out of the 460 that you probably had to begin with.
Do you know what? Out of the ones I turned down, I mean, I turned down Strangers in the Night, Frank Sinatra, I love that one. I turned down the Spanish Flea song, Herb Alpert, which, I mean, probably a lot of people will be glad I turned that down. and obviously I could have picked the Kinks, Sunny Afternoon. It was really hard. But the last one, I love the Beatles. So there was a number one in 1966, a double A side, Yellow Submarine and Eleanor Rigby. Yellow Submarine, I probably am in the minority. I actually like Yellow Submarine. I played it to my kids a while ago and they liked it. So it's good that Beatles music's carrying on with the next generation. But Eleanor Rigby, what a great piece of music. And McCartney, being the excellent musician that he is, went back to Eleanor Rigby in 1984 for his album Give My Regards to Broad Street. And he re-recorded Eleanor Rigby, which that would have been good enough anyway. But then he went on and added another 2 or 3 minutes to Eleanor Rigby, kind of, which is uplifting and positive and totally transformed the song. So if you've not listened to that, I'd say go out and check that on Give My Regards to Broad Street. But what a double A-side. I mean, the Beatles, I only listened to Rubber Soul for the first time last week, and it's only took me, you know, how many years? So many songs, you know, so many classics, and obviously Secret 60s hopefully will be a home for many of them.
Well, I hope you'll be listening to Secret 60s, not all the time, because we'd like you to carry on listening to Greatest Hits Radio, certainly in the mornings, that would be great. But what a great idea, Chris, and thanks so much for coming up with it and letting us produce it for you.
No, thanks, Ken. It's been a pleasure. And obviously, I know the couple of times that Greatest Hits Radio have played 60s music. I know yourself, you played a golden year a few weeks ago from 1969. And I absolutely loved it when you were playing Ring of Fire and it got excited. And that's the idea. You know, 60s music is still brilliant to listen to. And I believe there's a great audience out there. And I'm looking forward to listening to it.
Chris, thanks so much.
Thanks, Ken.